Good morning, children. Welcome to Kerlakkam Memorial CBSE School Mudol. Yesterday we have completed the word problems. I hope you understood and you have written in your fair notebook. And once again, I am telling you that to complete the fair notebook. So I am not going very fast. Slowly we are solving daily 3 to 4 examples. And this is not too much to you to maintain the faith. So, coming Saturday, your parents are going to come to school to show your fair notebook. Till that, you have to be ready with your fair notebook. So, whenever I will write the solutions, answers on the board, that then there only you should complete your fair notebook. Okay, let's start the today's concept, that is estimation. Page number 17. What is mean by estimation? One example I will tell you. Suppose there is a one marriage. Okay, in our house there is a marriage. So we are going to invite the people. Okay, marriage means we have to prepare some delicious foods so that we will call the chef to the home and we will tell them. They will ask us approximately how many people will attend the function. They never ask us to tell the exact number of people. They will ask us approximate. So around esht jana barbodri madvege, like that they will ask. Even we can't tell the exact number of the people who are going to attend our marriage ceremony. We will also tell them approximately. So now lockdown, so very pandemic situation, we will tell around 500. Okay, then there may be 490 something or more than 500 people also may come. Okay, we will tell approximately. So in our daily life, some situations we need to tell the approximate numbers. Some situations we cannot say the exact numbers. So that time we will use the estimation. What is estimation means? These will not be exact. Approximate the number will be there. These are called as estimate. So how to do the estimate? One more number we will use this for round off. So ಪೂಜಾ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ನಾವೊಂದು 18 ಮಂದಿಗೆ ಕರೆದಿದ್ವಪ್ಪ. ಸೊ 18 ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಇನ್ವೈಟೆಡ್. ಸೊ ರೌಂಡ್ ಅಪ್ 20 ಮಂದಿ ಬರ್ಬೋದ್ರಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ 18 ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಅಪ್ ಫಾರ್ 20. ಎಸ್. ಸೊ 470 ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಜನ ಬರ್ಬೋದಿತ್ತು, ಬಟ್ ನಾವು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೆಷ್ಟು ರೌಂಡ್ ಅಪ್ 500 ಅಪ್ರಾಕ್ಸಿಮೇಟ್ ಆರ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಅಪ್ 500. So the roundupping is only the estimation. Let's read the page number 17. Estimation news. So estimation related how news we will get in our daily life. They have given the examples. India drew with Pakistan in a hockey match watched by approximately 51,000 spectators in the stadium and 40 million television views worldwide. Here exactly we can't tell. Yes, because this is a huge number. Approximately 51,000 and 40 million through the television. And second one, approximately 2,000 people were killed and more than 50,000 injured in a cyclonic storm in a coastal area of India and Bangladesh. So in a Bangladesh and India there is a cyclone effect, flood has come. So in flood how many people were dead? So we can't calculate exactly. So that time we will approximately words we will use. So here 2,000 people were killed and 50,000 were injured in cyclone. Next, third, over 13 million passengers are carried over 63 km route of railway track every day. Can we say that there were exactly as many people as the numbers quoted in these news items? For example, in one, were there exactly 51,000 spectators in the stadium, or did exactly 40 million viewers watched the match on television? So whatever number we have told, that will be exact? No. Sometimes more than that also the people may watch, or less than that also people may watch. Obviously not. The word approximately itself shows that the number of people were never above these numbers. Clearly 51,000 could be 50,800 or 51,300, but not 70,000. Similarly, 40 million implies much more than 39 million, but quote less than 41 million, but certainly not 50 million. Yes, these are approximate. The quantities given in the examples above are not exact counts, but are estimates to give an idea of the quantity. Discuss what each of these can suggest. Where do we approximate? Elli now approximate anta use martivi. Imagine big celebration at your home. I told already one example. The first thing you do is to find out roughly how many guests may visit you. Can you get an idea of the exact number of visitors? No. It is practically impossible. The finance minister of the country presents a budget annually. The minister provides for certain amount under the head education. Can the amount be absolutely accurate? No. Every time we can't give the accurate number of, then it can only be reasonable good estimate of the expenditure the country needs for education during the year. Think about the situations where we need to have the exact numbers and compare them with the situations where you can do with only an approximately estimated number. Give the three examples of each of such situations. So they ask us to give minimum three examples where we can use approximately numbers. Already one I have given, that is our marriage ceremony. Approximately 1,000 people may visit. So this is one example. Take another example. There is a rally. Okay, take anyone. So rally related to rally in district wise rally, approximately 1 lakh people may join with this. So like this, they are telling us to give three examples. So they have given one sheet, strip of number, and there are some flags. 259, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71. A, find which flags are closer to 260. There is a number 260. So, to the 260, which flags are near? Answer is 261 and 63. Only 61 and 63, two flags are near to 260. But 67 and 69 are not near to 260. I'll show you on the board. 260, which flags are near? 261 and 263. And find the flags which are closer to 270, 267, 269. So these flags too are very near to 260. So we can round up 61 and 63 as 260. 67 and 69 are closer to 70. So these we can round up for 270. Okay. Locate the numbers 10, 17 and 20 on your ruler. Is 17 near to 10 or 20? The gap between 17 and 20 is smaller when compared to the gap between 17 and 10. So they have given very nicely. So 17 is closer to 20, not 60. Yes. So we will round up the 17 to 20. One example I'll show you. Very simple example. Round up thing. How to do that basic thing? It is yes. One number. Round up. 14 exactly idre around est agbodu yes around 14 is near to 10 or 20 you just think this is the gap here this much is the gap okay so this is the gap between 20 and 14 and this much is the gap between 10 and 14. So what I will consider 14 is nearest to 10. So 14 will round up as a 10. Yes. Now see the 18 is. Answer should be 10 or 20 because round up thing will be always in terms of zeros 10 20 30 40 50 like that so I should round up the 18 towards the 10 or 20 so 10 and 20 will be the answers so which one 10 or 20 to decide that we should calculate the distance between both so 8 is here distance between 10 and 18 is this much and the distance between 20 and 18 is this much So the smaller distance we should calculate. So 18 is nearest to 20. So 18 round up for nearest to 10 is 20. Okay. I'll take one more example. Here flag only I'll take. 260, 261, 262, 263. So 260 here one flag and here one flag. Then 300 is here. 270 is here. Okay. See 261 here one flag here one flag. 260 is here. The distance between these two flags is this much and distance between these. Two flag to the 270 is this much. So which answer we should calculate? The nearest answer is 260. Yes. So like this we should round up. And I will explain you the rules for round up. Round up nearest to tens. Round up nearest to I will take two examples 32, 98, 12, 53, number line. So directly how to round off the numbers? I will tell you. There are only 2-3 rule and very simple rule. So understand it. You can do this very easily. Now see round up in for nearest to tens. So keep it in your mind. Tens. So tens. Ten means 10 is having how many zeros? 1 0. So right? 1 0. Okay, I'll show you first one, then we will go for it. So 10 is having 1 0. I have written here. This is one rule. What has that? So nearest to tens, 100 or 1000. How many zero you should check it? That is first rule. So 10 is having 1 0. Write 1 0 over. So now our ones place has become 0. Next we should decide about tens place. So to do that, second rule is you should observe the ones place. Tens place is before place. Tens before place we should observe. If it is less than 2, next tens place write as it is. This is rule 2. Okay? Yes? If the next place is more than 5 are more than 5, this number, next number, we should increase. This is rule number 3. Finish. Once again I will tell you. So round up in for tens, write 1 0, then look at the tens place, sorry, tens before place, that is ones place. If the number is less than 5, next number write as it is. Okay? If the number is more than 5, next number increase 1. So this number increase 1 means 3 will become 4. Suppose if it is 8, it will become 9. Yes? Suppose if it is 4, yes? So 4. And if it is 3, so first number is 0. First rule is to write the zeros, then look at ones place. It is less than 5, so next number as it is. Then come here, nearest to tens, 10 having 1 0, write 1 0. Next look at ones place, it is more than 5, next number increase. Come to this, again 1 0, look at ones place, this is less than 5, so next number write as it is. So 212 will round up for 210 in nearest to tens. Again 1 0, look at ones place, this is less than 5, next number write as it is. 4 digit I will show. Okay, write 1 0 because tens is having 1 0. Next look at ones place, this is less than 5. But if it is more than, if it is 5 or more than 5, next number you should increase. Now it is 9, 589, increase 1. What will become? 590, 89 will become 90. So this is the answer. Okay, like this you should round up the numbers. So today I'll give you an homework, that is page number 90. Try these first. So they have given to round up this column. Round up these numbers to the nearest tens. There are 12 examples. Do this as your homework. Okay. Thank you. And remaining things we will continue in the next class. Thank you.